I mean, Born to Touch Your Feelings, that's also one of those beautiful Scorpions DNA songs. You know, talk about Sales of Sharon, and then on the other side, that's a Shankar ballad. Minor song, and one of those very strong Scorpions ballads, the early days. Not supposed to be a single or anything, just a beautiful melody, beautiful vibe. And I remember that the meaning of the song, I mean...
It had a message.
It's a message. Me, the song, I try to reach all of you and, you know, try to... I was born to touch you. I was born to touch
power,
your feelings.
Music.
You know, and so we had some... ladies, I guess, for the end of the song, and Dieter worked hard on it to get it all together. I think also Monica Dunneman was very much involved. There was a lady in there.
Exactly. They had all different languages, and they spoke in different languages. Now, Monica, her brother, Klaus Peter, who then became my manager, Klaus Peter Dunneman, he had a fiancée, Leila. And she was from Tahiti, and she came and she spoke.
Mm-hmm.
And she also did the French part because she knew both languages. And it was what, and on my Earthquake cover, Leila was the one at the back. She was like the lady standing in the back with holding the earth. And unfortunately, the year later, she died. You probably don't know that, but she died tragically from some unknown disease.
Mm.
And it was very sad, but that was the last thing. And she is there, one of those voices at the end of that song.
I can't remember who had the idea, you know, to put all those voices on top of the other, like this layer of vocals.
It was in the studio we had there. It came, we were talking about it, and then someone said, wouldn't it be great? And then in no time at all, we had
different languages.
Yeah. Maybe also Japanese, maybe that's why we had people from the Japanese fan club there, because I've seen a photo recently.
Yes. So it was also one of these ideas. I mean, the song, I Was Born to Touch Your Feelings, but at the same time, even back then, like trying to bring the whole world together in a song, all those different voices, languages, and putting one on top of the other.
Yeah.
So in the end, you couldn't understand a word, but it became a beautiful collage of voices and connecting the world, you know, in this piece of music. And that's the idea behind it. And we picked that song just recently for the MTV Unplugged, and played it in the set, and we haven't done that song. I can't remember that we ever really played it live.
No, you didn't.
Back in those days.
No, we didn't.
You
we
know,
tried it once on one of the reunion shows, but we couldn't actually get it
never
to work
out
yet.
Really.
No.
Yeah.
But acoustically,
you know,
it would
this
work.
Song needed a special treatment, you know, and for the MTV Unplugged shows, it worked out very nicely, you know, and yeah, and it still means a lot. This is one of the songs, you know, this is fantastic. And I know for our fans, this is one of those Scorpions ballads that really, they are right. They are just there, and this is what this kind of song, the way it should be, you know, and it hits the right emotions.
I played the keyboards back then, but there was, on the previous albums, we had another keyboard player. And we used the keyboards very sparingly in the Scorpions albums. Particularly on that one, there was hardly any keyboards. I just remember there was a Steinway in the thing, and I played some octaves or whatever, you know. But, yeah, so not a big deal.
I think I could feel the chemistry was right here, and I was finally in the right band after all the many years of playing music.
Take My Force for me was a part of the way to really come to the point where our career have to be. It means that it was a puzzle in the whole picture.
My personal favorite at that time was always Virgin Killer and Trance. Those two. Taken by Force, I had mixed feelings because I had already mentally left the band now, but of course it does have some great songs on it, you know. So with hindsight, still, I have to say, despite it having Wilbur and the Sky and Seth Sharon and the others, my favorite from that period was still Entrance and Virgin Killer, you know.
We had this change with the drummers, you know, with Rudi Lennerts left for health reasons. Herman joined the band. For the songwriting, since Herman lived in England for quite some time, you know, his English was much better than all of us could speak English. I don't know about Uli. Your English was pretty good.
I could speak English, yeah.
You know, but Herman came in, had fresh ideas, you know, and his rock and roll attitude, you know, so we wrote some cool stuff, like He's a Woman, She's a Man, and so much more later on throughout the 80s.
Taken by Force, as I said, for me, beginner album to try out the chemistry.
For the chemistry in the band, this worked very, very well. And this was like Taken by Force when Herman joined the band. And it was just like, in a way, the missing link. The sky.